Victoria Oil and Gas has switched on the second of two power stations built recently in Douala in Cameroon. Well, to tell us about production and what this means for the company, we're joined by Chairman Kevin Foo. Now, Kevin, you've described the commission of the Logbaba station as an outstanding example of cooperation between all partners. Now, if that's the case, then is it the case of chocks away and your business is set to fly?
Hi, Sarah. Thanks for the opportunity to speak and catch up. And I'm actually calling from Cameroon, so I'm on the spot and seeing it all happen here. It's a good example, as you point out, of three diverse companies and a government working together very rapidly to make a project happen. In brief, we signed this contract on the 29th of December last year. The same day, Eltaka, the equipment supplier, mobilised its fleet of gensets. We were already digging some pipeline in anticipation, and NEO, the client, was clearing the decks for clear and rapid clearing of the equipment once it was shipped and got to the port. Now, all this happened, and today we announced that the full 50 megawatts were online and going into the grid. It's actually a little more, I believe, about 51 or 52 because of the higher efficiencies in the units than expected. So that's great. Proud of our achievements.
So, Kevin, how ambitious are you about how ambitious are Victoria Oil and Gas about their production profile over the next 12 months?
Well, we have a target of 10.4 or 10.5 million standard cubic feet today to reach for 2015. So if we average that for this year, that's, I think, a significant jump in last year's production, almost 2.5 times. So that's quite an achievement. I do believe we'll meet that. And then I think in general terms, I'd like to approach double that again for 2016, up around the 18 or 20 million standard cubic feet per mark per day. So we don't look too far ahead because you can get caught up in too much enthusiasm, and these things have to be brought on practically and with proper engineering. But I believe that a doubling of our current target up to 10.4 to around about the 20 million standard cubic feet per day ought to be, a good one for the company to seek.
So what exactly would that mean to your bottom line in terms of profitability, sort of net?
Well, I'm a metallurgist by training, so accounts and profitability and so on are a little bit of a foreign territory. But in terms of revenue, it would take us in the 20 million standard cubic feet today would take us into about the $100 million range, or $90 or $100 million range in terms of revenue. And profit is a matter of how the accountants decide to declare it. But I look at revenue and cash flow, and it would put us up in the high 80s, I think, in terms of cash revenue coming back. And that's a good spot to be in.
So we started this conversation talking about partnerships. I'm thinking about the longevity of these partnerships. What about a long-lasting or a new contract with Cameroon Energy Company, NEO?
Well, we believe that the contract will be extended. It's currently set for 2 years and extendable by mutual consent, and we think that will happen. And we do feel that once everyone's comfortable with the efficiency of these machines and how the gas is effectively transferred and supplied to the gensets, NEO will want to put in more permanent facilities. So I would expect that in 2 to 3 years' time, we would be looking at permanent fixtures of gensets that would either supplement or replace the existing rented temporary units.
So in a nutshell, and finally, Kevin, you've got gas, you've got customers, got net assets, making profits. So what next?
Build on that. I think we have a great company now. It has turned a corner. We have something like 18 million cash at the moment at our disposal, and we'll be building up that cash in this year and next. We have to look to drilling the next couple of wells. That will happen sometime next year, I'd expect. They're not cheap. They're expensive and complex wells, but they'll be drilled with the view to giving us the extra gas to get really ambitious with capturing this market down here in Cameroon, which is quite large in terms of the amount of gas that is needed and the amount of power that can be supplied. So it'll be focused on Cameroon and getting us further up the operating profits curve and production.
So that sounds as though you've got a big war chest in terms of cash. So no likelihood at all of you coming back to shareholders for extra cash?
No, as a shareholder myself, I know the pain that we all went through in the last few years and the dilution, and really that's an absolute last resort. I never say never, because opportunities actually come up where shareholders can accept an equity placing, but there's nothing on the horizon and we have no plans.
Kevin Fu, Chairman of Victoria Oil and Gas, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thanks, Sarah. Bye.